Hello everyone, my name is Martje from Crafty Crow Designs. Today I'm going to create another card with the Let's Stick Together stamp set from My Favorite Things. For the card of today, I wanted to do something that I have never done before. I have always wanted to make a one-layered card, so that is what I'm going to do. I also recently bought masking paper from Simon Says Stamp, which I'm going to use to create the one-layered card. First, I was checking where I wanted to place all the stamps. So at the bottom, I wanted to stamp the sentiment, and in the middle of the card, I wanted to stamp the cute little cacti. After I figured out where I wanted everything to go, I first started by stamping the flower pot and the sentiment. I am stamping these with Memento Tuxedo Black ink, which is a Copic friendly ink. And I first started with stamping the flower pot, as that is what is going to be in the front of the card. And the cacti, of course, they are inside the flower pot, so that is what I had to stamp second. To be able to stamp the cacti on top of the flower pot, I also had to mask off the flower pot first. So that is why I also stamped the flower pot on the masking paper from Simon Says Stamp. So now that I have masked off the flower pot, it is time to stamp the cacti. And as you can see, the cacti are overlapping a little bit with the flower pot. And if I would not do it this way, then it would not look as if the cacti were in the flower pot. And as I'm going for a one-layered card and want to create the background with Distress Oxide inks, I also have to cover up the cacti with masking paper. So that is why I also stamped the cacti on the masking paper, and now I am covering them up. I was also thinking ahead a little bit, so I decided to keep the cacti stamp inside my stamping platform. And later on, you will see why I did that. So now it is time to start working on the background. I only wanted the background to be on the top side of the card. So I did not want to have any Distress Oxide ink on the bottom of the card where I have stamped the sentiment. And to create the background, I am using the Distress Oxide ink Candied Apple and Picked Raspberry. And I am also making sure that the colors are blended well together by going back and forth between them. I also wanted to have a heart pattern on the background, and for this I am using the Love is in the Air stencil by My Favorite Things. I am making sure that the stencil is not going to move on the background of the card. So that is why I am taping it to each other. And I'm also making sure that the whole background is not going to move, so I also taped it to my glass media mat. To create the hearts, I'm going over it with my Distress Oxide ink Candied Apple. But you will see that in the end, there's not much left of it, to be honest. Because while I was creating the background, I was thinking that I would like a little bit of shimmer. So I grabbed my shimmer spray and I moved my background to a box, and there I sprayed the shimmer spray on top. I always do this in a box because otherwise my whole glass media mat will be covered in shimmer. And here you can see the result. And you can really see that the shimmer spray also reacts with the Distress Oxide ink a little bit. So everywhere where the shimmer spray has hit the background, it has become a little bit lighter and it has a nice shimmer to it. So now the background is finally done, I can take off the masking paper. And when you take it off, it is so nice to see the nice white crisp image that comes from underneath it. So I'm going to use my Copic markers today to color the cactus and the flower pot. For For the cactus, I'm using YG67, YG17, YG13, and YG01. These green colors have a real nice contrast with the pink and red background. It really helps with making the cacti pop from this background. And as always with Copic coloring, I am going from darkest to lightest. And I'm also working in two layers, but I did not show all the Copic coloring today in the video. As the two cacti, I colored them the same way. For the right cactus, she has this little flower on top of her head, and I'm using RV14 and RV11 to color in the flower itself. And for the center, I'm using E09. And for the flower pot, I am using a combination of E09 and the E30 series. I also pulled in the E09 to give the flower pot a reddish shade. And for the E30 series, I'm using E35, E37 and E39. So now the coloring is almost done. But in the end, I also was not really sure about the pink colors that I picked for the flower, because it was kind of fading into the background and I felt that the pink color did not really match that well. So I decided to also go over it with the R22 and I thought that would look much better. And then for the bottom of the card, I also felt that it was really white in contrast to the top of the card, and I wanted to tie it a bit more together. So I decided to add some splatters to the bottom of the card. And for this I am using the same two colors that I used to create the background. So I am using Candied Apple and Picked Raspberry. And I diluted these two colors with a little bit of water so that I could splatter it on the page. And then I thought I was done, but then I noticed that the spikes on the cacti, they were not that visible anymore. And there was a reason why I kept the stamp in the stamping platform, and this is exactly why. Because with the masking, of course I did not mask off all the little spikes of the cacti. And the Distress Oxide ink, it covered up the ink a little bit from the spikes. So they were not that visible anymore. So I decided to stamp the cacti again to make those spikes visible again. And of course I also masked off the flower pot to prevent stamping the cactus on the pot. It is a little detail to stamp it again, but I really do feel that it makes a lot of difference and it just finishes off that cactus. And now I'm going to adhere the background on the card base with my tape runner. I'm leaving a white border around it as I feel this really helps with making this background pop. And that already finishes up this card. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, please give me a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.